Like me, if you love plants and you love Arduino, there is nobody to stop you from creating a smart device that lets you know that your plant is thirsty. So if you have done a little research, you might already know that you can find these sensors very cheap. You may also have already found out that there are two kinds of sensors, resistive sensors and capacitive ones. Of course, you have chosen capacitive ones. Now you might be thinking of buying a capacitive sensor for yourself, but before buying them, there's something you need to know. There are some sensor modules that are defective and have design flaws. These are some things you need to look out if you're buying one. Look for this voltage regulator. If you see a resistor like this, it also means that it is using this NE555 timer, which has higher operating voltage rating. Make sure it's TLC555 instead. And finally, look out for this broken ground connection if you don't want to solder it yourself.